Hi developers, are you ready to build a something practical and stylish? Today, we are crafting a responsive blog layout using HTML5 and CSS. This project is perfect for showcasing your writing or portfolio work while ensuring it looks amazing on any device. Learn to create a modern responsive blog layout that works across all those devices. We will design a blog page with post, tags, and event comment sections. Plus, I'll show you how to make it responsive using CSS media query. Let's get started. First, let's create the basic structure of our blog using HTML5 semantic elements like header, articles, and footer. For that, we are going to use Notepad++. Along with that, we'll use some images and other creativity. So if you wanted to learn from scratch, please be available from start to end of this video. And if you have not yet subscribed to this channel, feel free to hit your like and subscribe. It always helps me and promotes my content to YouTube. This will also help us to reach with broad audience sets. So you want support will make better for me. For starting with this, we will use your doc type, first exclamation symbol, doc type, and then HTML. This will ensure all the tags which we are using are working perfectly fine. Here we'll use HTML language. So lang equal to in double quote en, and next will be my head where I will define my meta character set. Meta char set equal to in double quotes UTF-8. This is done. After that, I wanted to define meta name as well. Meta name equal to in double quotes viewport content equal to width equal to device initial scale equal to 1.4. We'll add title. Here we'll add write curriculum blog, close of title. That's it. After that, because we are going to integrate CSS, we'll add that for CSS integrations link relations equal to in double quotes style sheet h reference equal to styles.css. This is done, and here we'll close header as well. Our main content begins from here, where I will define body tag, where we'll include header. These are the tags which we are going to use to make this block interactive. Here I'll add h1 my block h1. After that, we'll use navigations, and under this href will define home. Here will add home, and e tag will be closed. We'll try to add multiple times for this one. About, contact, everything about. Now that's it. Now here I will close my navigations tag and then header. After this, I will start with main. By using these tags, we'll make this website interesting. Section will be ID equal to in double quotes post. Then article class equal to in double quotes post. Let me save this so that we'll get smart suggestions accordingly. This is my HTML, so I will select hypertext markup language file, and here I will add index.html. Now you can see my all this codes becomes highlighted. Now under article, I wanted to add h2, and here I will add blog post titles. So here, what is Python? I will add here. And then h2 will be closed. Now to start with this, we will use some content where I will add paragraph class equal to in double quotes meta. This is done. And here I will add posted on November 22, 2024. I will add pipe here and tags span and web development. Close off span. This is done. Again, I will open one more span where I will write CSS. Now, after this, I will close paragraph as well. So this is somewhat it's done. Let me try to close body first and then try to see how it looks. You can see we are reaching till here. Now we have added three menu items and this is what it contains. Now, to continue with this, I will add one paragraph under this here, P, and I am just writing some random detail. Python is programming. Maybe I will source from Google what is Python. I will get some contents and then I will copy and paste it here to showcase some contents on my web page. We'll close the paragraph here. We'll add here AHREF to just showcase the main highlighted content. Rest all will add into read mode. I'm not giving any path here. We'll add class equal to read mode. Read more, double quotes close. Here we'll add the text. So it will highlight just few lines and then it will give me a read more options. After this, we'll add article close tag. Now that's it. Let me try to add same thing multiple times. Here we'll have what is Python 2 text posted on 23rd November. This is for desktop development. I'm just making some differences so that we'll have some contents available. This is for Python. What is Python 3? Then API development, CSS, and rest all looks good. Let me save it and refresh the page. We are done with three sections. Here, I will close section as well. After that, we'll add sidebar. So here, we'll add a side ID equal to in double quotes sidebar. And this, I will add H3 and then tags. Then S3 will be closed. After that, I will add an order list tag. And under this, we'll add some list. So here I add li, then web, li closed, and here I add some link, href, double quote, hash. We don't want to provide any path. I will copy and paste it multiple times so that we should have some data at sidebar. API, desktop, Windows, maybe iOS. Perfect. Next, I will close the order list, aside, then menu. We'll close menu as well. Sorry, main. And here, we wanted to add footer as well. So this footer contains my copyright information and other details about footer. So and post it, copy, and the assembly column to write C circle 2024 all. Rights and resolve under rivalhood. Now this is done. Here I will close the paragraph. We'll close the footer as well. And we have already closed body as well as a table. That's it. Let me save it and refresh our website. Now we have everything available. After this, I wanted to make this better. We are using header for the navigation bar, main for the block content, and footer for copyright informations. This structure is plain semantic and ideal for SEO. Now, let's style the block using CSS to give it a polished look. As of now, you can see it here. Everything is looking in left alignment and there's no styling. Nothing is available. This looks like a proper page. This looks like a plain simple page We want to make this professional. That's the reason we are going to use typography, spacing, and layout to make it more better and visual appealing. For that, we'll use another file, and here we'll write body. First, we do the modifications for body. Before we'll continue with the CSS, if you have any questions, feel free to add in the comment sections. And for most important part, if you have not yet completed, start building it, this complete project along with me, where you'll learn a lot. Rather than just watching this video, I would suggest you to pause and then continue building it by your own. Now, first I wanted to use font family, colon, Arial. You can use any styles. I'm just using it for demo, serif, and then semicolon. Margin colon is equal to 0. And then line height, EIGHT, colon 1.6. And then curly braces are closed. Let me save this under the same projects. And here we'll use cascaded style sheets as the type and styles.css. Now, when I will refresh my page, I will have some different look and feel. Now, our website started converting into professional's look. Post this, we wanted to modify for header. Header, I will give here background. And once we'll save this, we'll also get smart suggestions in Notepad. That's the beauty of Notepad++. Here, I will use this background color. Text color will be #FFF. Semicolon padding will be 1 rem 0. Semicolon, then text. Text alignment is center. This is done. My curly braces will be closed. Let me see a refreshed page. Now, my header navigations A, and under this, we'll add color colon #FFF semicolon. I'm using ASCII codes. If you don't know about it, search on Google or check my previous video of HTML ASCII codes. Pixel text decorations. You can see it here. None. This is done. Now I wanted to modify for display. Display will be flex. Here, flex wrap is margin 20 pixel and that's it. Let me see it and refresh this page. Now I can see we got this text where home, about, and contact informations are available. And right side panel, we are able to get web API, desktop, and iOS. Once we do further modifications, we'll get more aligned way. Now, let's start with #post. Under #post, I will add, let me see if we have used it or not. Or maybe just post. Flex 3 is this category margin. Right, colon 20 pixel, and that's it. Next is dot post. Here we'll make the changes for border. 1 pixel solid #DDD semicolon margin bottom 20 pixel, and then padding will be 15. Let me save it and refresh my web page. Now you can see we got some other formatting available. After this, we have to work on meta, footer, and other things so that this website looks much better. Here, let me modify for post H2, post H2. Inside the curly braces, I'll just do the modifications for color. And here, we'll just add simple color. That's it. This is done. Next is my post meta. Post and then meta. inside the curly braces, font size 0.9 em, then the color will be 7 semicolon, and then that's it. I wanted to also modify read mode so that it should look interactive. Color will be FF. Text decorations will be none. Next, I wanted to close the curly braces. After this, I wanted to modify for sidebar. So under sidebar, we'll add few things like flex 1, then padding will be 15 pixel. We are keeping common thing for few of the, if you observe, we are keeping most of the things common so that it looks professional rather than F4. And the border will be one pixel solid and hash DDD. This is done. After that, footer. And footer, I wanted to keep everything similar. Your background is as 333. Color will be as FFF. With text alignment, center, and padding will be 1 rem 0. Now we are done for everything. If you want, even we can make it more attractive. So you can see it here. We got this block generated. With this padding, we have created a clean and professional look for the block. The sidebar, post, and footer are all styled for clarity and readability. To ensure the block looks great on all devices, you can also use CSS media queries to make this layout responsive. I will leave it to you where you can add @media and add some other CSS customizations. This is very helpful where it looks more professional in terms of website development. Here, if you found any difficulties while adding the media into your CSS file, let us know in the comments. I will share solutions with you. But this is a task for you where you can start making the changes in your code. This code ensures that the post and sidebar stick vertically on smaller screens, making the block mobile friendly. For an interactive touch, let's add simple comment sections below each post. You can also implement this latter as a challenge. Now it's your turn. Let's make this block your own. Here are a few challenges for you. Add a comment section for each post. Include a search bar to filter block post, and enhance the layout with advanced CSS animations or transitions. These three are challenges for you. First, try it out. If you found any issues, let me know. I will be happy to help you. What's the first feature you would like to add in your blog? Let me know in the comments, and don't forget to share your blog links below. I would love to see your creativity, and if this looks interesting, I will be happy to share any one blog on my channel. That's it for today. You have built a modern responsive blog layout that's ready to shine. If you enjoyed this tutorial, give it a thumbs up and subscribe for more web development tutorials or projects. See you next time. Thank you for watching.